Good morning, neighbors. Let's sing this song called Treasure. Your breath is like rain. Your word, it sustains me. I've come to this place with intentions of finding you. Your truth is a lamp, your wisdom my light. Oh, and I'm seeking your face with intentions of finding you. Finding you, Lord, and I would run for a thousand years if I knew every step would be getting me closer. I'd swim to the ocean floor, for my Lord is the treasure. My Lord is the treasure. Your breath is like rain. Your word, it sustains me. I've come to this place with intentions of finding you. Your truth is a lamp, your wisdom my light. Oh, and I'm seeking your face with intentions of finding you. Finding you, Lord, and I would run for a thousand years if I knew every step would be getting me closer. I'd swim to the ocean floor, for my Lord is the treasure. My Lord is the treasure.
If you read in the book of Matthew, Jesus uses terms like this in his parables. And in Matthew chapter 13 and verse 44, it says, "Again, the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and hid. And for joy over it, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field." You know, the kingdom of heaven has to be the greatest treasure on the earth to us, where when we find it with joy, we'll go and get rid of everything that we've held so dear to us and go and buy the field that has that treasure within it. You'll hear about these people with metal detectors, treasure hunters. You know, they're willing to go to do so much work and sweat and all these things just to find, you know, an old coin or some kind of treasure. But the kingdom of heaven is so much more valuable than any of those things. And we hold on to so many things of this world instead of just selling it to go get rid of all these things just to have this treasure within us. And it says, "Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls, who, when he had found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and bought it." Again, it's the question, is the Lord your treasure? Is it more valuable than anything in this world to you? Or are you holding on to things that really hold no value? And it's sad, this world, you know, it's so material based now that we put all our time and effort into these things of this world, to have more treasures upon this earth. And yet we know that it will all perish and pass away. So Lord, let us grasp hold of something that is of great, great value. I know one time I was playing out in the snow with my wife, and I kind of threw her in the snow, and I did. She grabbed hold of my glove and ripped it off as I was throwing her down, and I didn't realize it till I think that evening. I was like, you know what? My wedding ring was inside the glove, I think, because I don't have it anymore. And so you go out there, you're asking people, does anyone have a metal detector? Somebody have something? We go out into our friend's front yard, and we're digging and digging in snow out there. And, you know, I still remember the great relief when you hear that beep, beep, beep. And we start digging around, and my wife kind of kicked, and it popped out of the snow right there on top. And such great relief that you have, because you realize that is a much more valuable, much more value than just a, you know, I mean, it was so precious to me. That's the ring I got married in. I need to find this. And you're willing to go and put in all this effort in the freezing cold to find this thing of great value to you. So really, we have to look at the kingdom of heaven like that. Is it of value to us? Is it worth putting in the effort? Or is it just something that, well, sure, if you want to throw it to me, I'll take it. But Lord, let us not have that attitude. This is what Jesus taught us. So in Jesus Christ's name, amen.